ناظرین السلام علیکم لائیو فون ان انٹریکٹیو پروگرام ٹیل کلاس روم کے آج کے شمارے میں آپ کا خیر مقدم ہے میں رہوں گا آپ کے ساتھ آپ کا اپنا میزبان نیاز بٹ اور میرے ساتھ رہیں گی حمیرہ شفیع
ہیلو اینڈ السلام علیکم ناظرین آپ سبھی کا بہت بہت سواگت ہے اس شو میں ناظرین ہمیشہ کی طرح پروگرام کی شروعات میں آپ سب سے ایک اہم بات شیئر کرنا چاہتی ہوں اور وہ یہ ہے کہ زندگی ایسے جیو کہ اگر کوئی ہنسے تو تمہاری وجہ سے ہنسے تم پر نہیں اور اگر کوئی روئے تو تمہارے لیے روئے تمہاری وجہ سے نہیں اینڈ فرینڈز ود دس گڈ تھاٹ آئی وڈ لائک ٹو سے تھینکس ٹو ایوری ون فار یور لو اینڈ سپورٹ اینڈ فار کنٹینیوسلی واچنگ دس پروگرام تھرو آؤٹ دس ایئر اینڈ وی ہوپ دیٹ یو کنٹینیوسلی ڈو سو ان دی اپ کمنگ ایئر ان شاء اللہ تعالیٰ اینڈ یا ہاؤ کین آئی فارگیٹ ٹو سے ہیپی نیو ایئر ٹو ایوری ون
جی ہاں پوری ٹیلی کلاس روم ٹیم کی طرف سے آپ کو یہ نیا سال مبارک ہو اور امید کرتے ہیں کہ یہ سال یعنی 2018 آپ کے لیے ترقی عافیت اور شادمانی بھرا سال ہوگا ٹیلی کلاس روم ایک انٹریکٹیو ایجوکیشنل پروگرام ہے جس کے دو جز ہیں پہلے جز میں ہم ناظرین ہمارے قابل و فاضل استاد کسی ایک چنندہ موضوع پر لیکچر ڈیلیور کرتے ہیں اور اسی لیکچر پہ لیکچر کے اختتام کے بعد ختم ہونے کے بعد ہمارے جو ایکسپرٹ ہوتے ہیں ہم اور آپ ناظرین آپس میں انٹریکٹ کرتے ہیں بذریعے فون نمبرز یا بذریعے ای میلز حمیرہ
یا فرینڈز یو گاٹ دی ٹو میڈیمز ٹو انٹریکٹ ود اس فرسٹ آف آل یو کین انٹریکٹ ود اس آن ٹیلی فون اینڈ آر ٹیلی فون نمبرز آر 248-1813 اینڈ انادر نمبر از 248-1832 اینڈ انڈیڈ یو کین آلسو سینڈ یور سجیشنز اینڈ ایوری تھنگ آئی مین آل سجیشنز اینڈ فیڈ بیک اینڈ کوشچنز اینڈ آل آن آر ای میل آئی ڈی دیٹ از ddktelclassroom ایٹ دا ریٹ آف gmail.com اینڈ آل دوز ای میلز ول انکلوڈیڈ ان ڈیورنگ دس شو
Yeah, you can also join us on our official Facebook page, Tele Class Room. You can give the valuable suggestions, feedbacks there also. You can also watch this program live. This is also live streamed on the YouTube where you can also watch this program. Also give your feedbacks and valuable suggestions there also. Today's topic will be, it's the time to have to introduce our topic. Today's topic will be writing skills and our subject will be English. A lecture will be delivered on this writing skills by our teacher, today's subject teacher, Sheikh Gulzar Ahmad. He is a lecturer, boys, higher secondary school, Beerwah. He has been very active and very participating in these programs also. Yes. And I have been watching Mr. Gulzar on the Facebook also. He has been conducting various programs there also to introduce the subjects to the students also. Very thankful and we are having the pleasure to host you here, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And today's expert is Mehraj-ud-din Zargar. Mehraj-ud-din Zargar had been the ex-director academic state board of school education. It's really pleasure to host such a talented expert here because he has developed, I will want to add to the introduction of our expert today, he had developed the textbooks of English from class 1st to class 10th, which is entitled as the Tulip series. All the students must be knowing that. So you should be know that he is the hand behind these your Tulip series. And he has also developed class 11th and class 12th book series entitled Blossom, I think is like Blossom First and Blossom Second. Indeed, we are really thankful to host you here in these chilly mornings here. Thank you. Very thankful you are here. And I also want to thank two teachers who are not present here, Abdul Majid Pare, headmaster high school is high school Pushkar Budgam, and also the escort teacher Parvez Ahmed Sheikh, he had been the escort teacher of the same school. And students,
Friends, I believe that this program is just incomplete without the presence of the students.
From
and today, we have with us the students all the way from Government Higher Secondary School, Pushkar Budgam.
Very thankful, all of the students, you have been here. Itni sardi mein yahan aane ke liye, bahut shukriya.
Thank you so much for coming here.
And you will be impatiently waiting for the today's lecture. Topic is writing skills. It will be shortly started, but only after this short break. नाज़रीन फिर एक बार खैर मकदम है ब्रेक के बाद लाइव फ़ोन इन इंटरेक्टिव प्रोग्राम टेल क्लासरूम। लेक्चर शुरू करने से पहले हम पहले मेहराज-ud-din जरगर साहब कुछ कहना चाहते हैं।
यस, अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाह। बिफोर वी इनिशिएट द डिस्कशन ऑफ हाउ टू इनकल्केट द राइटिंग स्किल्स अमंग द स्टूडेंट्स, आई फील दैट वेल इट्स मैंडेटरी टू जस्ट शेयर विद द स्टूडेंट्स दैट सिंस टुडे इज द लास्ट day of the year 2017, and tonight we shall be ushering in the year 2018, and I wish my fledgling scholars, young students, a very happy new year, and I wish those students who have appeared in the examination, I wish them success. I wish you happy, peaceful and healthy new year.
Thank you so much Zargar sahab. It's time to start today's lecture. So, Mr. Sheikh Gulzar Ahmad Saab, please.
Thank you very much, sir. Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam, sir.
How are you, students?
Yeah, well, sir.
Okay, all the way from Pushkar, distant place from this very studio. And how was the travel?
This was cheering, sir.
So, did you enjoy the travel today morning?
Yes, sir.
You must have left quite early today, right?
Yes, sir.
That's very nice. So, how are you feeling inside this very room now and we are in this interactive class?
Yes.
Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it was really cold outside, I understand. But okay, I think it is better now. You're feeling warm
yes,
now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's very nice. So, I hope that I will enjoy today's interaction with you people, and yes, today's topic, you know, a very important topic, and as it has already been announced that it's writing skills, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just tell me, dear students, how do you feel when it comes to writing? If somebody asks you to write something, what I understand is that okay, reading, I feel it's quite comfortable.
Yes,
the listening, okay, we can do it. And this speaking, okay, broken here and there, we can manage. When it comes to writing, what do you...
Difficult, one voice.
Is it difficult?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I understand. You know why? Why the single answer? All of you speaking, sir, it is difficult. Because this is the problem with all of us, that most of the times what we have been doing is that students are mostly writing for the exams.
Exactly.
Students are writing preferably for their teacher.
Exactly.
You have never thought that, okay, writing can be some other affair. Something. It's a public affair. We can write anything. And everywhere there is a chance to write. Mm-hmm. And let us try to do that today so that we remove these inhibitions of getting scared when it comes to face a blank paper. So what is writing simply? It is putting your thoughts, communicating your thoughts through
part
language.
Of communication.
That's very simple. Communicating your thoughts, your ideas, whatever is in your brain, you communicate that through a medium, through language, that's writing. Okay?
Yes,
now, before going to a thorough kind of process, we'll follow a particular process, and I hope that we'll come up with a wonderful piece of writing here today. But prior to that, I'll tell you that there are different styles, or there are different kinds. There are different types of writings.
Writing.
Okay, I would like to go through that quickly. For example, we have expository kind of writing. Okay,
yes,
you should keep these things in mind. We will go through this, and then we will come to the second part of our lesson. That is, I will tell you how to develop writing over here. We'll go through different processes, and we will come up with a wonderful piece of writing here, inshallah. So, the first style, or the first, maybe one kind of writing. Maybe there are, you will find books, they show that there are six, there are eight. But what I have, after going through this area of writing, what I have come to understand is that there are basically four important kinds of writing. At least our students in class 9th, 10th, and I hope that students of class 11th and 12th, definitely they are watching right from their home. I really request their parents also that they should watch today's class, and because we'll be talking about, we'll be doing something very important here, and they will come to know that what are the different kinds of writing. For example, I said it is expository. Yes, what comes in expository writing is very simple. It is explaining things in process. It is giving facts, figures, defining and classifying things in a logical order. For example, where do we use expository writing? We mostly your textbooks, some recipes, cooking recipes and all that, news stories in newspapers, all the news stories, except opinions given by people or those editorial pages. They are not expository writing, but rest, reports, etc., they are. So, for example, if somebody asks you how we can write through this style of expository writing, the simple answer is how to prepare a cup of tea. The instructions you, I hope that we have been working on this, and once we did one of the exercises on preparing a cup of tea, the instruction, taking the, those instructions, following them, if we put it in writing form, that's how to prepare a cup of tea. That's an expository kind of writing. Then immediately we move to another most important genre of this kind of writing, that's descriptive writing. That is descriptive writing. And when it comes to descriptive writing, yes, it's absolutely poetic in nature, describing places in detail. Places, people, objects, events, situations, and visualizing. Through descriptive writing, what we do, we visualize. Yes, what is seen, what is heard, what is felt, what is smelt, okay? These are the, some of the imperatives. So, where do you find, see, all the kinds of your these writings, whatever comes to your examination, or wherever you feel to write, they will come under these four headings. For example, if you want to write poetry, descriptive writing is the best.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, if you want to write journals, if you want to write your daily diary, yeah, exactly, or writing about nature and all that. For example, if I take this cell phone, I want to describe this cell phone. I'll just begin like this. Oh, unexpectedly, this cell phone has a long screen, a big screen, but it's very light. It's very light. It's made of aluminium, glass, and stainless steel. Okay, it's the casing is gray, this golden gray, right?
Yes,
so the, all those words that I use, I try to very clearly describe the cell phone. By the way, if I had used one of the words, this cell phone is very attractive and it has a market value and like that, so that means I was trying to use some other kind of writing, for example, persuasive. We'll come to that, but I didn't use that. I exclusively tried to describe. So, yes, the cell phone. That's descriptive kind of writing. Then, if we move to narrative, the important one of the narrative important kinds of writing is narrative. It is telling stories, events, happenings, character, dialogues are there. Okay, it has beginning, middle, and end. Okay, there are actions full of disputes and conflicts.
Yes.
Right.
Yes,
so, for example, very simple terms are novels, short stories, poetry. You can try your hand there as well. So. Example, any story from your textbook, you know, that is story, particularly story type, that can be narrative writing. Then we come to persuasive, which is mostly used, I think you find it everywhere, particularly used in advertisements, and it can be, it is, in other words, this means reasoning, speaking for and against, arguing, taking stands, urging someone to agree with you. So, calling someone to come in action. You got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. For use, in use, we, our opinions in newspapers, editorials, advertisements, review books, music, movies. So that way, we can go to persuasive writing. Now, two important points that we should keep in mind.
Okay.
That's coherence and cohesion.
Cohesion.
While writing anything, any paragraph, these two important linguistic techniques, one is actually related to our thought process, another is related to linguistic skills. For example, if you go to coherence, it's nothing that you will find that you will find a word that this is coherence. No, it is the logical thought that you think, it is the organization of a particular writer that you make through a logical kind of you sequence it in a particular way. We'll come to that more precisely when we will go to the writing task. Then, yes, cohesion. It's very important again, and this is actually about linguistic devices, connectors, or what else you call them? Linkers. Right? So there are so many of them for addition, for controls, for compare, for scans, for examples, for consequence, for certainty, condition, summary, reason. For example, also again, in addition to, because, since, owing to, there are so many. You have these in your books. Now, this is the most important area which I want to focus on now for next 1 or 2 minutes. What I have observed in examinations, when you students come and sit in examinations, or maybe you are asked to write a particular kind of writing. For that matter, if it is an essay, you write it. Okay, that's fine. But unfortunately, you don't follow a particular format.
Yes, sir.
You got my point?
Yes, sir.
And most of the times you find that, okay, you expect that, okay, we'll be given some, if there are 7 marks, you know, the evaluator, or the person who is evaluating my paper, he will give me 7. But he doesn't only see your writing, what you have written. He also concentrates on the format that you have followed. Whether it's a letter, it's a poster, it's an email, it's a report, whatever it is. It has a particular format. So unless and until you follow that format, you are missing the mark. So please be careful while you are writing a particular kind of writing. So, dear students, there's a first standard form of writing an essay, right?
Yes.
Even essay has a format. For example, in the first paragraph, it has 5 paragraphs. It has 5 paragraphs. The first paragraph has introduction, then you can have 4 lines, okay?
Yes,
supporting your introduction. Then begins the body. In body, again, you have 3 different paragraphs. And each paragraph has a topic sentence followed by 2 sentences. Paragraph number 2 followed by 2 sentences. Paragraph number 3 followed by 2 sentences. And then conclusion, again, a topic sentence with 4 sentences that gives the whole review of the rest of the essay, what you have written. Now, coming down to formal letter. Writing formal letters. Writing formal
letters.
So how do you write formal letters? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 points that should be kept in mind while you are writing a letter. For example, immediately at the beginning, it is sender's address, then it is date, then it is receiver's address, subject, salutation, greeting, body of the letter, 3 or 4 lines, ending, and finally the complimentary subscription. You got my point?
Yes,
so
sir.
That's letter writing. And moving next to this is, this is report writing. You got a point?
Yes,
and report writing, for example, it has headline, it has byline, where it is the name of the author. Then it is place line, where you write while from you are writing it. Then it is lead. In reports, you have lead. In lead, lead should catch the reader's interest. Most important information is given in the lead items. And it definitely answers 5 W's. That means 5 WH questions. Where, who, which, what, when. Right? Okay.
Yes,
then notes. Coming down to notes again. It has the first point, that's the name of the place, then the title notes itself, then what you are writing there, then what is the date of issue. In body, you have 3 important points, event, date of event, time of venue. Then finally, name of the authorized authority who has to sign that this notes. And finally, his designation. Is he a secretary of the school or is it someone else?
Sir, before you proceed.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I would like to know that should we focus on form or meaning while writing?
Absolutely, that's a wonderful question and very much related to the topic. Should we focus on form or meaning? See, if we focus on form, let me put it like this way, and there's a famous idiom, I will use it here, that it is putting the horse in front of the cart, or putting the cart in front of the horse. Because actually students are way. Let us try to say something. Later on we can correct that. So form means grammar. If you are before speaking anything, you start correcting yourself or you start learning grammar, that's not going to work. For communication, for improving of language, let you say something. Communicate. Later on, when you are able to communicate, somewhere when you get some kind of confidence, okay, I will come up with the inhibitions or those effective filters of correcting the language. So first comes meaning, that's followed by the form. Later on, form will come itself. Okay? Sense. Okay. Now, see, this is informal letter writing. Here you have the address. Okay? Then date, dear father, you write something. And this is the body, subscription and writer's address. Now, we come to email. Now, very common. Presently, we are writing mails here and there. So in email, we have date, then to whom you are writing it, his address, then CC.
Sir,
yes,
what do you mean by CC?
Yes.
What do you mean by CC?
Oh, nice, fine. So CC stands for carbon copy. CC stands for?
Carbon copy.
It means, if, for example, what's your name?
Tahneet.
If Tahneet wants to write an email to his teacher, for example, say Gulzar sir, right?
Yes,
and
sir.
She at the same time wants to send, I'm a teacher, and she wants to send the same email to the headmaster of the institute. So she can put headmaster's address here and my address in two columns. That means the same email will go to me, and at the same time, it will go to the headmaster. You got my point?
Yes,
so
sir.
That's carbon copy of the same email. Then comes BCC. Now,
BCC?
I definitely...
Some have seen it on our smartphones and laptops or computers, but some will notice what is it. So can you tell what is it?
Nice. Fine. That's very good. So it is blind carbon copy. It is blind?
Carbon copy.
Yes. Now, what does that mean, blind carbon copy? It is, again, if a student or someone wants to send a mail to some friend, but at the same time he wants to inform others that I have sent a mail to a particular person. But this time he tries to conceal, hide things, that Mr. A should not know that a mail has also gone to Mr. B.
Yes.
So that way, at that time, he should not send it on CC. He should write the addresses whom he is also wanting to send the same on BCC. That is blind carbon copy, so that the people who will receive the mail will not be aware that some other person has also received the same mail. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Wonderful. Then we put subject, the important thing, why we are writing the
email.
Two or three words, okay?
Yes, sir.
Then greetings, dear sir, dear madam, whatever it is. Then there's body, ending, subscription, name, and designation. Then this is send button, or if you want to send it later, then save button, okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, a very important point that we will go through today. Let us stop here at the mail.
Yes.
And concentrate on one of the important things. See, whatever you write, whatever I have shown you, believe me, everywhere you have to write a paragraph.
Paragraph.
You have to write a
paragraph.
And so let us try and focus how to write a
paragraph.
Let us see how to write a paragraph. Let us write an email. But actually, we will write a paragraph that will be in the email. You got my point?
Yes, sir.
And today, while writing paragraph, we will follow a method called power method.
Power method.
In other words, power writing process. Okay? It's one of the shortest activity where you can quickly write, complete a writing task. For example, you can ask me a question. For example, what's power?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But I'm sure that in last few days we have been talking to each other. And I know that I have mentioned this power most of the times in front of you. Can somebody among you tell me? So many hands going up. Okay, is it an abbreviation or is it a word where we need meaning? Just tell me. What is power?
P stands for preparation. O stands for organization.
Okay. Thank you. That means, yes, Mehraj. That means it's an abbreviation. It's an
abbreviation.
Okay. Now one by one. What is P?
Preparation.
Preparation of ideas.
Preparation. Okay. Now what is O?
Organization.
Okay. Nice. Main likhta hu. Organization is also okay. Then?
W.
Okay. What is
writing?
Oh my God, that's fine. Right. And then what is E?
Evaluation.
Excellent. And what is R?
Review.
Rewrite.
Okay, it is?
Rewriting.
Review or rewriting, okay?
Yes,
or
sir.
Redrafting, fine. Now, immediately, let us follow these five, one, two, three, four, five. Let us follow these five steps and try to come up with writing. Will you come along with me?
Yes, sir.
Would you love to come to and write something?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's fine. So, what is P? P preparation, it means, can you simplify it? I want from, yes, I will hear. Yes, yes, that boy. Please give the mic to that chap. Yes, what is P, dear? Can you prepare?
Mindstorming.
Oh, that's fine. It's mindstorming. Okay, we can say brainstorming also. It is brainstorming. What else can we call it?
Mind mapping.
Fine, mind mapping. Fine. And what else can we call it? Can somebody else add one more word?
Collecting of ideas.
Fine. So let us start it from here. Okay, fine. Let me rub other words. Let us try to brainstorm our mind wave or collect ideas. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Because you began it and you will conclude it. Okay, dear friends, let me create a situation. For example, quickly, suppose you have purchased something online. Okay?
Yes,
you purchased something online, but you are not happy now. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, I ask you to write an email to the website at the owners, whosoever they are, asking them that I have purchased a particular thing, item, but there is some problem with it. You are not happy.
Yes, sir.
Write them what do you want. What they should do for you, okay?
Yes, sir.
Let us, this is the problem in front of us, okay?
Yes, sir.
Let us try collectively to find a solution to this problem, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what will be the first thing? Let us see online, the concept came here online. Let us see what can we buy online, okay?
Yes, sir.
You starve your brain, you think for a while, 1 or 2 seconds, come up with the ideas and tell me what can you buy online. Yes, please.
The computer.
Please, one by one. Let us go to the girl. Okay, let us start. It is laptops. What else?
Clothes.
Clothes.
Furniture.
Cell phones.
Computers.
All the gadgets.
Bicycles. Oh, sorry.
It is anything.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. That is. Yes, yes, yes. That's wonderful. Because we don't have space, I'm sorry, I cannot take all the ideas. But I know.
Yes,
This is the big difference. See, I will tell you here a very important point to all of you. Let's see, writing and thinking, there
thinking.
Are two different things.
Yes.
That's why it is difficult. When you asked me the question in the beginning, sir, writing is difficult. Writing and thinking, they are two different things.
Yes.
Because our mind, our brain, it thinks. Sometimes it is here in the hall, and in the very next moment, it will be on the road.
Yes,
and on the next moment, it will be on the hill station.
Yes,
because it is free to think anything, anywhere in the world. But writing is not that. Writing is completely logical. It must have some sequence.
Exactly.
It has some logical beginning, ending,
excuse
middle,
me, sir.
And yes, please.
What is the difference between study skills and writing skills?
Oh, my God. Okay, fine. So, writing skills and study skills. Definitely, these are two different skills. When it comes to writing skills, it is simply what we are doing here. Writing anything, maybe a letter, whatever it is. But study skills altogether different. Here we need gathering of information, retention of information, perception. It is study skills can be, dear son. Study skills can be used for any other subject. For mathematics, you need study skills. For any other subject, you need study. But exclusively, writing skills are used here in the writing, right? In study skills, simply retention, perception, gathering of information, okay?
Yes.
And then using it for the later time. Okay, coming back immediately to this. Let us select. See, we have come up with so many ideas. Let us go specific now. Let us concentrate on one idea. Where do you like to focus?
Computer.
Okay, dear. Let us
computer.
Go to computers. Okay. So let us say, suppose computers. Okay. In some computers, what can we buy? What is the chance?
Monitor, CPU.
Okay. We can go for keyboard. We can go for mouse. We can go for CPU, and we can go for monitor as well. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What I think. What shall we go from here? What have you actually purchased? Would you, what would you like?
Mouse.
Okay, let us go to mouse. Let us go to mouse. Because that is easy. Let's go to mouse. Now, you purchased a mouse. And yes, in mouse, you have two important things. What is in mouse?
Right key and left key.
Has?
Right key and left
right
key.
Right click. And left click, okay?
And scroll wheel.
It has also scroll, good. It has also scroll wheel. It has also
scroll wheel.
So let us say, after 2 days you got this mouse, according to the problem, you have now some problem with the left, right click. Okay, let it be right click. So what is the problem with the right click? In 2 days, It started acting up. I use the word acting up. Acting up means behaving, malfunctioning, or behaving erratically, right?
Yes, sir.
It's a phrasal verb. I use it here. Anyway, it started acting up, and after 2 days, now it is 1 week. It has completely stopped working.
Stopped working.
Okay, that's one problem, right?
Yes, sir.
And then, let's go to, because we mentioned scroll wheel. Let us go to scroll wheel. What has happened to scroll wheel?
Change direction.
Wrong direction.
It has? How do you know? How do you know just change the wrong way? Yes? Exactly, on screen it moves here and there, exactly. Okay, that you mean that it is not now functioning properly.
Yes,
you
sir.
Give one command, you want to that screen should highlight here, but it goes somewhere
wrong.
Yes, okay, wrong direction, nice. Okay. Now the point is, these are the problems with your mouse that you purchase. Now the point is, what will you do? There are two options available, remember. Two options are available there. What should he do? Normally we understand, either refund or replace.
Yes,
either refund or
replace.
There are only two things possible, refund or
replace.
So I think we will go with replacement.
Yes,
we'll
yes,
go
sir.
With?
Replacement.
Let us replace. Repent is not fair, okay? Yes, but sir. In replacement, one thing is to be done. You have to return the defective.
Yes, sir.
The setback, return defective one. Return defective one back. So that is the complete. Let us stop here. That is the mind map. That is the
mind map.
Okay? Yes, immediately, sir. Come now. Now, please, I hope that you remember all these things. Let us quickly go and develop an outline. Develop an
outline,
outline from this. Okay, first of all, 2 days. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is the first point that came to our mind. So what happened? Mouse. Problem with mouse. Okay?
Yes.
Right button.
Acting up.
Right button.
Acting
okay,
up.
Not necessary. Now 1 week.
Scroll.
Stopped. Very good. Stopped. Now moving to this scroll wheel. Scroll wheel. Going to wrong
directions.
Fine. And then action.
Replacement.
Action. And what's the action?
Replacement.
Okay. Replacement. And what we will do? Return the defective.
Defective unit.
Return. Defective one. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is the second point. First, it was preparation of ideas. This is your outline. This one?
Outline.
Let us immediately rush and try to go for the first draft. Go for the
first
draft. Let us go to first draft. Okay, right. Okay, dear students. Now, we will not go to these things you understand now. We will straight away come to greetings and body. Dear sir. Dear?
Sir.
Okay. I, for example, let us start it like this. Let me help here, okay?
Yes,
let
sir.
Me help here for the first drop because always we have paucity of time when there are online classes and it's very difficult to manage things in time, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I
purchased.
Now, I, see, this is the way. Follow me and develop this kind of habit. For example, I am writing this to complain about a computer mouse that this is flaw because here you are not, remember one thing, here you are not concerned with grammar, not concerned with punctuation, not concerned with this spelling, whatever comes. If it is wrong, don't worry. It can be wrong. Because later on we have another stage where we will go to editing and evaluation. Here you can correct things, okay?
Yes, sir.
So I'm writing this to complain about a computer mouse that I purchased from your... I will deliberately try to do... commit some mistakes here, because later on I will correct that. So I will show you how to edit or evaluate things from your web page. One week I purchased from your web page 1 week ago. Let me write. The mouse have stopped working and the scroll wheel goes
wrong direction.
Gives wrong directions. GIVS gives wrong directions. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Next para. I would appreciate if you could send, could ke baad I am writing send, third form. If you could send me a replacement and I will return the defective part in the original packing. In the original
packing.
Regards. You will write here. Now, this is for example our first drop, okay?
Yes.
First drop. Then after going through this first drop, what we are supposed to do, you will see whether I have committed any word, for example, vocabulary, wrong vocabulary. I used one word only, web page. I should have used
website.
Website. That's very good. And let us go to somewhere else. I think, yes, sent.
Yes, sir.
Let us go, vocabulary I left. Now let us go to grammar. In grammar, I committed two mistakes. Sir, after could, after models, first form of verb is used, by I use the third form. So sent, it should have been sent here. And yes, sir has pointed me. See, it is subject verb agreement. The mouse have, it is singular and should be has. It should be has. Okay? So that way, accordingly, if you have some punctuation problems, correct them here.
Yes.
You got my point?
Yes, sir.
So if you have any other problem, correct them here and then come to the final draft. And remember one last thing. If it is an examination, you can't go all through these procedures. But this is process of writing. Practice it. Practice P-O-W-E-R. Always at home. Don't never ever write, start writing, and this is the final draft. No, that's wrong. And remember one thing. Whenever you go for this editing, leave it there before sending it or before giving it somebody else. Come after 1 day or 2 days to this writing again. You got my point?
Yes,
because if you go and start just editing it here or thinking whether it is correct or incorrect, all those thoughts, they are there, they are very much there.
Yes,
so they won't allow you to correct the thing. So come, come with a fresh mind after 24 hours, after 1 day, and go to this writing again. You will change major things here and there.
Yes.
And it will be a wonderful piece of writing, right?
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
I
sir.
Hope that you will go back home. I give you two tasks. First, you go for final. I say editing, we have done it here.
Yes.
Revision you will do. And I hope that I will visit your school and I will
yes,
see
sir.
The final draft
yes.
there. Okay?
Yes, sir.
With these
so
words.
Sir, excuse.
I have a question, actually.
Yeah, please.
I've seen so many students who are very good in reading. And they have like good command on
yes.
language.
Yes, sir.
But when it comes to writing,
yes.
they made so many mistakes, like in spelling and in punctuation.
Yes.
So you tell me, what are the main reasons behind this?
Exactly, exactly. That's, see. The most important thing is that, I think I have answered this question in the beginning, that we should always develop the habit of
writing
everything,
practice.
And whenever we get a chance, write for 15 minutes, half an hour, whatever comes to your mind. That is free writing. I couldn't get some chance to talk about free and guided writing. Write freely, write your diaries, and that will give you the time, to come up to the mistakes, and you'll be able to correct your mistakes later on. So with these words, I really am thankful to all of you.
Thank you so much.
for patiently hearing me. Thank you. Thanks, one and all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Really wonderful and energetic. Really wonderful and energetic. And students, you also have been very responsive. Bahut response tha aap logon ka. Isse class bahut energetic hua. Inshallah, Rahman, Nazreen, aap bhi istifada honge isse. Ke writing skills aap bhi develop karenge, koshish karenge. Lekin jo kuch reh gaya hoga, waqt ki tang damni ki wajah se Gulzar saab ko bhi class ikhtitam karna pada. Jo kuch reh gaya hoga, hamare expert Mehraj-ud-din Zargar saab hamare saath hai. To unke saath banenge hum, lekin ek chote se waqfe ke baad. ناظرین آپ دیکھ رہے ہیں لائیو فون ان انٹریکٹیو پروگرام ٹیل کلاس روم وقت ہوا ہے انٹریکٹیو سیشن کا آپ ہمارے ڈاؤن دا لائن سکرال ہو رہے نمبرز پہ کال کر سکتے ہیں یا ہمارے لائیو ای میل IDDD کے ٹیل کلاس روم پہ بھی ہمیں ای میل کر سکتے ہیں ہمارے پہلے کالر ہمارے ساتھ جڑے ہیں ملک الطاف ویری ناگ سے السلام علیکم
السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ
الطاف صاحب السلام علیکم
السلام علیکم نیاز صاحب السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ
جی
سر سارے پینلسٹس کی خدمت میں
ہیلو آپ کی آواز نہیں آ رہی الطاف صاحب آپ اپنی ٹی وی سیٹ کا والیوم کم کیجیے
ہیلو سر السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ
جی الطاف صاحب
جی سارے پینلسٹس کی خدمت میں میرا عقیدت برا السلام علیکم
نہیں آئی ایم سوری ٹو سے آپ کی آواز ہمارے ٹون پہ نہیں آ رہی جی ہیلو فرمائیے
ہیلو سر
فرمائیے
سر میرا کوشچن ہے جو معراج صاحب ہے ان سے میرا کوشچن ہے واٹ اسٹیپس نیڈ ٹو امپروو دا رائٹنگ سکل ایٹ انٹروڈکٹری اسٹیج ایٹ ایلیمنٹری لیول واٹ اسٹیپس نیڈ ٹو امپروو دا رائٹنگ سکل ایٹ انٹروڈکٹری اسٹیج اور ایٹ ایلیمنٹری لیول
اوکے سر سر معراج جی آپ سے زرگر صاحب پوچھنا چاہتے ہیں الطاف صاحب واٹ آر دا اسٹیپس steps to need to improve the elementary level writing skills
well it's a very nice question and I tell you that well so far as this writing skill is concerned
ji
it's a joint venture don't you put the whole of it into the teacher's domain
okay
it's a joint venture in the sense that well parents and teachers have to collaborate together and then they can make an attempt to inculcate writing skills among the students. Okay, to begin with, I will suggest that the parents should keep a journal or a diary and ask their child or ward to write down whatever he feels about, anything. Writing is a creative activity.
Okay.
And once you start penning down the ideas, you're creating something. And while creating, it has a therapeutic value as well.
Okay.
You are giving a vent to your feelings or whatever you have in the heart of hearts. And at the same time, you're creating a new world for yourself. So I will suggest that they better keep a journal, which in common parlance you call diary at home.
Okay.
And then even when schools arrange parent-teacher meeting, the parents should share the experiences of their wards with the teacher.
Okay.
And teacher should also share the experiences, his or her experiences with the parents. So that, as I said, that it's a joint venture and they have to work together to inculcate the writing skills and the writing habits among the
students. Thank you, sir. So we can say it like that, it's a joint and continuous effort.
Of course it is. And of course it has to be
continuously.
Otherwise you cannot, once you develop anything or once you write down anything, it will not get stuck there.
Aap katakalami ke liye maafi, ek aur caller hamare saath jude hai, Delhi se MK Bhatt. Hello.
Everybody, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
All of Kashmir Valley students and the experts. I am glad to see to some extent the lecture of this teacher. But before going for this, writing skill is the most playable method when students should understand and write from childhood. It is as good of writing the books, as good as writing the skills. So first of all, I want to draw the attention, dear sir, you have written the letter, dear sir, respected sir, I want to draw your kind attention about the fact that you have shown how to go for the writing skill. It should be first of all the subject, whether it is complaint, it is proposal, it is anything theory, there should be subject. Then the student should learn. And this girl has told about how do we do the punctuation sentences. Yes, girl. Yes, lady. You should start paragraphs one or two and you can get the punctuation right. Then you will go for diaries. It will become difficult. So write punctuation in paragraphs. Short set. Then you can learn the good English. Thank you.
Ji. जी एक ईमेल व्हाट्सएप के सवाल का बाद में जवाब देंगे पहले एक ईमेल हमें मौसूल हुआ है अस्सलाम वालेकुम टेल क्लासरूम इज वेरी इंफॉर्मेटिव प्रोग्राम प्रोडक्टिव एंड इन एंड एनर्जेटिक आई होप दिस प्रोग्राम्स विल बी कंटिन्यूड इन द फ्यूचर माय क्वेश्चन टू आवर एक्सपर्ट मेहराज-ud-din जरगर साहब इज सर डोंट यू थिंक सर सच क्लासेस आर मिसिंग इन आवर स्कूल्स
In the first instance, let me thank the emailer for thanking the all those who are involved in the teleclassroom. The second question, what's the second question that it you said that well,
classes are missing.
Yeah, of course. I tell you, the other day we had a detailed discussion on the Facebook, and one of my friends said that education is a failure, a total failure in the state. Mm-hmm. And I asked him, well, what's too obvious? It doesn't need too much to say in words. Mm-hmm. And I requested my friend to come up with certain measures or identify the factors which are responsible for the failure of the education system. And then I, on my part, identified two factors. That is the less involvement of the students in the classroom and then the interactiveness in the classroom. In classroom, we see most of the time it is a one-way traffic. That is, the teacher most of the time speaks and the students are the patient listeners. A teacher is not able to ignite and stir the thinking of the students. The best thing will be, it will be my humble submission to all my fraternity to try to ignite the minds of the students and stir their imagination. Okay, once we are able to stir their imagination, I am sure that, well, things will be very easy for students to put
and
things in black and white.
Yes, things will be changing also.
Mindset of the students.
Mindset
also.
Of the students.
That's true.
Changing. एक और कॉलर हमारे साथ जुड़े हैं जम्मू से मोहम्मद शफी ऋषि अस्सलाम वालेकुम खैर मकदम है आपका प्रोग्राम में
अस्सलाम वालेकुम And yes, sir, even though I am not an expert in this particular subject, but still there is one question in my mind which definitely I would like to ask it. My question to expert is, because nowadays there is a trend, cursive writing trend in school, is it helpful for enhancement of this writing skills?
जी जी शुक्रिया मोहम्मद शफी शुक्रिया कॉल करने के लिए आपके सवाल का जवाब हम जरगर साहब से पूछेंगे अभी कोशिश करेंगे जानने की पहले एक ईमेल हम शामिल प्रोग्राम करेंगे मीर असमत अस्सलाम वालेकुम टेल क्लासरूम इट वाज ऑसम बाय शेख गुलजार अहमद इट वाज रियली ग्रेट कीप इट अप गॉड ब्लेस यू आई हैव अ क्वेरी फ्रॉम योर एक्सपर्ट आई एम गुड इन फैक्ट्स imaginations and sequences but sir I am very weak in grammar how much it is necessary to correct me in grammar for being good in the writing skills sir?
That's a very nice thing and let me before I answer the question let me share my experience when I was of her age or when I was a student myself mm-hmm. I would try to write down things on the paper but the moment I completed one paragraph I will tear the piece of the paper and will make a fresh attempt to write down the same thing. So probably I had not had the confidence at that time and then I had not learned the art of writing skill that time. So my answer to the question will be that you write things, never mind about grammar in the beginning. Once you go to the editing, and I'm sure that if you are writing on a system, say on laptop or on your PC, now we have this facility on the PC and on laptop that it will automatically point out the incorrect grammar or even the incorrect spellings also, and then you can check your grammar, check you can check your spellings on the system there. Mm-hmm. It's not when I was a student, you know, I was given a beating for even a minor spelling mistake or even a minor grammar mistake. Mm-hmm. Now you have the things very, very easy for you, and I'm sure that that way you are very lucky that you have all the things which definitely will facilitate you to write down things in a very nice way.
Thank you so much for such a nice answer, sir. Ek aur caller hamare sath jude hai Magam se, Wajid Ahmed. Khair magdam hai aapka program mein, sir.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Walaikum assalam ji. Khair magdam hai.
Yes, I'm Wajid from Magam. Gulzar sir, they had been my teacher and it was a very nice lecture.
Thank you.
And Mehraj sir, their speech is very beautiful, very beautiful. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And Gulzar sir, they didn't have enough time like every other teacher. Mm. They didn't have enough time to cover every single thing.
I mean
whatever they covered, it was very beautiful and it was very coherent.
Thank you. Any query or any question from your side, sir?
I don't have a question. There can be a lot many questions, but I don't have any question as such right now, but it was very nice. Whatever they covered, it was very beautiful.
Thank you, sir.
I'll put things to it, and then we live in the 21st century, and previously we used to have the entertainment and we used to have the information.
Yeah.
In the modern era, the era wherein you live, we have a new thing, we call it infotainment. We pass on the information with a sugar-coated pill in the form of the entertainment.
Yeah.
And I tell you that one more thing that I want to share with my viewers is that in a present-day situation...
We'll continue with you, sir, before taking a call. Please. First, we'll take a call. Shiraz Manzoor, Beerwah se humare saath jude hai. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Ji, welcome to Tele Class Room.
Actually, today was an extraordinary lesson delivered by Mr. English Guru.
Mm-hmm.
Jai Gulzar, sir.
Ji.
I'm Shiraz Manzoor from Middle School, Hadapanzu.
Mm. Nice. Thank you for calling, sir. So you want to add something?
Yes, sir. My question is, what is the difference between writing and handwriting?
What's the difference between writing and handwriting? Sir, respond to the question.
There is a very close connection between the writing and the handwriting. I tell you that the more cohesive, the more beautiful hand you have, and the more lucky you are. In the sense, I'm reminded of Gandhiji when he had this grouse in the heart of his heart that, well, he didn't have the very good hand
very
there.
Good hand, yeah.
So if you have a good handwriting, and now we have a science wherein we can just tell a person, the personality that he has, even from handwriting. If you write legible, if you write neat and clean, that is That's a feather in your cap. Apart from writing a very good English, you write a very good hand, I am sure that people will love to read your writing. And then, as I said, that it's one more feather in your cap.
So we'll take a call first. Malik Suhail Khag. Welcome to Tele Class Room, sir. Hello?
सर मलिक सर लुकीपुरा से बोल रहा हूँ सर
जी फरमाइए अपना सवाल पूछिए सर हेलो
हेलो सर
जी जी अपना सवाल पूछिए Galiban line drop hui hai Suhail sahab ki ek interesting sir
you continue to have the questions and the queries from the students in the meantime I will be sharing one
more thing I have an interesting email from here Mushtaq Ahmed but he wants to say it was really energetic class I am feeling blessed to have the such teachers and expert on my TV screen thank you so much for such beautiful and the most interesting part what we want to share is that my question to Zargar sahab is my age is about 55 years but I am not good at writing Can I improve and is there any scope for me?
I tell you that there's
ye
no
sabse
age
baat ye hai ki chahat hai inme
seekhne ki. I tell you that, my dear, there's no age bar in learning things. One has to be very open in learning. Age doesn't matter. And when you say that, well, I want to write even at this age, I'm sure that you are not that old. 50, I don't consider an old man. You can develop the writing skills. And my humble suggestion will be to start and write down things and to begin with. Take a chance. And then afterwards, you have to read things. You know, it's only when you read things that you add to your vocabulary, add to your information. Then you add polish to your what you write.
So one more call is here. Javed Rahim from Budgam. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Tele Classroom.
Sir, Sir, my question is how we can improve our handwriting.
How we can improve the handwriting. It has been already answered, but it is not related to this program. But still, if a simple suggestion,
I tell you that, well, the thing that you can improve upon your handwriting is that you have to have a bigger font. If you are familiar with the computer fonts, try to have a bigger font and try to add niceties in the alphabets or the letters there. And a bigger font will definitely make things more clear there. Okay. And when you continue to write, and with the writing process, with the continuation of the writing process, I'm sure that you will develop beautiful handwriting. I wish you good luck there.
Okay, so we have an email here also. We have received an email. Shahid Nazir is writing from Rajbagh. Assalamu alaikum, Tele Class Room. Wishing you all happy and prosperous New Year.
Thank you.
We wish you also the good and happy New Year. My question to the expert, to the lovely expert he has written here.
Thank you. May God bless you.
What's your view on my finding writing skills has been also improved by e-introduction, like writing emails using social networking and other things? Because it gives an easy access to write anything on the program.
Thank you. And I will share one more important thing in this program. Nowadays, we have reached the stage wherein we have the Amazonization of knowledge. So I will repeat the word. It's Amazonization.
Amazon.
You go on Amazon.
Amazon.
And then we have the latest term that has come recently is Amazonization of knowledge.
We'd like to add one more call. Please. We have so many of the callers on the line. Mr. Abrar is with us. Hello. Welcome to Tele Class Room.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Ji, sir. Walaikum assalam.
Sir, पहले मैं शुक्रिया ये कर रहा है ये चाहता हूँ इस क्लास रूम का ये हो रहा है इंग्लिश के टॉपिक का बहुत अच्छा था सर
जी
जी सर मसला ये है कि जो ये राइटिंग स्किल है ये एक आर्ट है ये एक हर स्टूडेंट में नहीं हो सकता है सर कंपटीशन क्यों नहीं होता है महीने महीने के बाद या छह छह महीने के बाद जो पता चले कि कौन स्टूडेंट कहाँ जा रहा है
जी जी जी
अगर ऐसा होता तो पता चलता सर किस पे कितना स्किल है राइटिंग का अभी हम जॉब रेडी करते हैं जिसका जॉब हमने लिया तो बस लेकिन हम क्लास रूम में महीने महीने के बाद या साल साल के बाद कंपटीशन क्यों नहीं करते कि कौन सा बच्चा कहाँ जा रहा है राइटिंग में
So I tell you that, well, I agree with the, I don't agree with the first part of the question. The second part, I agree with you.
मैं कतकलामी के लिए माफी वक्त की कमी की वजह से हम आप दोनों का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया करते हैं और स्टूडेंट्स आपका भी बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग आज के प्रोग्राम का वक्त इख्तिताम पजीर होता है दीजिए इजाजत अल्लाह हाफिज़ और नासिर ड्राइव करेंगे तो